Then the next thing is that it is a letter, so you have to be conscious of the element of writing a letter, right? You have to do a proper salutation. Sometimes you add your address. Yeah, I think I did add my own address in the last cover letter I've written. In this case, you do not really need to have a title, right? But some people go as far as putting off a title. Of course, the title is generic, it's a cover letter. So naming the document appropriately can help avoid having to write a title. But in the end, you should end it with a closing note and, of course, sign it with your name and all that. So bear in mind, it is a cover letter, meaning it's a letter and it's your first impression. Of course, it's covering your resume. So people may not even have the chance. You have to approach it with the mindset that people may not even have the time or chance or even interest to look at your resume. They want to see how well you've sold yourself on the cover letter. Then you can convert it into a portable document format. This is because if you send it in a Word document format and there is a mismatch in the software being used to access that document, all of what you've written may be skewed or disoriented or scattered around, and that is not good visuals. Visuals is key. Ensuring that it is well spaced, ensuring that you're putting it in the right format that anybody can access and be able to get the information you're trying to pass across is very important. So make sure that it's in a PDF format or an image format, whatever is going to help you make sure that how you've written your cover letter, how you structured it, is how it appears. You can use that methodology to send it through. And very importantly, submit the cover letter. There's no point writing the cover letter if you're not going to submit it with your resume. So you can decide to attach it to your resume. So there are a lot of website that can help you attach documents together as one package, or you can send them as individual documents, right? Because if you attach it, it's going to show if your resume has like 3 pages and your cover letter is like one page, it's going to show that you have a 4-page document. Whereas you may want to just have it as one pager, then your resume comes as a different document and you send both as a folder or as a package. So yes, that is what I've had in mind to say. I know I've rushed through, but I thought it would be best for us to have it more interactive if you have questions. Thank you for listening. So anybody has any questions?